No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work.
Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I am Pastor Agnes Williams of Agnes Williams Ministries, here to discourse with you once more on principles enshrined in the Word of God. For the past month or so, I was directed by the Lord to read out the entire book of Psalms. And I finished eventually, and I have found such beauty, such strength, such encouragement, such truth in Psalms that I still am preaching in the book of Psalms. Today, my scripture is from Psalm 62. And my topic is Trust in God at All Times, New International Version. Psalm 62, Trust in God at All Times. And I can say what I'm saying, not because it's just written in the Bible here, but because I have proven and I've had times in my life that I have had to do that. And God has never failed me yet. I've put my trust in God in so many situations. In fact, every situation that I think I could have handled and those I knew I couldn't handle, I trusted in God. Sometimes I just relaxed and depended on Him to see what doors He would open or what victories or what He should do or remove. And God has never failed. That's why I can say trust in God at all times. Psalm 63 is just about 12 verses here. The first verse is, my soul finds rest in God alone. My salvation comes from Him. How true, how beautiful, and how true. I think I qualify to say that because I'm 70 years plus and I've experienced God. There were times when I ran away from Him and He drew me back. One time I said to Him, you drag me back to you. But I am glad it was His love. Because if I did not or was not drawn back to Him, the enemy of my soul would have destroyed me and drawn me into hell. But God, that was not His plan for me. And today I thank God, and I want you to trust in God too. Trust in God at all times. When the times are good, you have plenty of money, you have a little bit of money, you have plenty of food, you have no food, you have plenty of clothes, you have no clothes, you have your children with you, then you are alone, you have a job, then you don't have a job, you're young, then you're old. Trust in God at all times. I have proven that God, our God, is faithful. He is faithful. He never disappoints those who put their trust in Him. Sometimes people say, you were talking about God. So who must I glorify? Who must I praise? There is only one person or one being worthy of praise in this world and in all the worlds. Almighty God is worthy of all praise because He is God all by Himself. I'm going to read from Psalm 62 in the NIV version. It says, my soul finds rest in God alone. My salvation comes from Him. He alone is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I will never be shaken. How long would you assault a man? Would all of you throw him down? This leaning wall, this tottering fence? They fully intend to topple him from his lofty place. They take delight in lies. With their mouth, they bless, but in their hearts, they curse. Have you ever been there? Where the people who you trust, you can no longer trust them. The best of friends, you can only trust them so far. Even me, I don't like anybody to trust me too much because I'm not God. Put your eternal trust, your whole trust in God, and trust people, human beings, a little bit, not much. So I thank God today that I can testify that by trusting God at all times, He has brought me through many dangers, toils and snares, through many illnesses, through broken relationships, through loss of relatives, through death of my families. Sometimes you go into such depression and you don't realize it, but God draws you back and He says to you, I am here, I am the Almighty God. I am the God of man. I am the God of the heavens and the earth. And you remember all the good things God has done for you. And you can sit quietly and talk to God. You don't have to be in a big crowd to testify. Sit quietly below a shade of a tree, rocking in a hammock, driving your car by yourself, sitting by the beach side, and experiencing and glorifying and praising God for His goodness, for His love. So my soul finds rest in God alone. My hope comes from God alone. He alone is my rock and my salvation. He's my fortress. I will not be shaken. My salvation and my honor depend on God. He's my righty rock, my refuge. Trust in Him at all times, verse 8, O people. Pour out your hearts to Him, for God is our refuge. Low-born men are but a breath. The high-born are but a lie. If weighed on a balance, they are nothing. Sometimes people put their trust in men of who in high authority, men who have riches and wealth. But we should not put our trust in man. We should put our trust in Almighty God. And if He wants the wealthy person, the rich person, to bless us, He will speak to them and He will make sure they do it. But put your trust in God. Do not trust in extortion or take pride in stolen goods. Though your riches increase, do not set your heart on them. And this is something that most men yield to, most human beings yield to this. God give us some wealth. He will give us a job, give us a nice house, give us a nice car, give us children, give us extra money, we can travel, we can help people. And sometimes, when He does that to us, we become proud, haughty. We look down with scorn at the other person who seems to have less than we have. It says, together, both the low-born and the high-born men, together only a breath. So we must not trust in extortion. We must not trust in robbing people of what is their rightful due. Some people take delight in robbing people of their money, their property, their character. Just rob them of everything because they feel they have more power than them. But God doesn't like that. We mustn't take pride. Some people take pride in stealing all the time, stealing from people, stealing from their bosses, stealing from their employers, stealing from their neighbors. God says we should not take pride in stolen goods. We should not be glad to extort from people or steal from them. And if our riches increase, We should not set our heart on them. We should not say, I have, and show off. Oh, say, thank God, God bless me. God, whom can I bless now with some of what I have? Say, one thing God has spoken, two things have I heard. That you, O God, are strong, and that you, O Lord, are loving. Surely you will reward each person according to what he has done. That's a very short psalm, which is 1 to 12. And you see here, the psalmist knew and realized he had experienced God. He had a relationship with God. He loved the Lord. He turned his life over to the Lord. And he knew, he has proven his life, that God is strong. That God is a stronghold. And that God, most of all, that God is loving. Oh, how he loves you and me. He loves us with an everlasting love. That's why we ought to love others also. Just as he loves us, we must love others. We must learn to forgive others. I mean, sometimes someone does you wrong and you forgive them, but you can no longer trust them. And you can no longer keep company with them. But that doesn't mean that you hate them. You still love them. If there's an opportunity to do good for them, you will do it. You will try not to speak ill of them. You try to just leave it alone and love them, because the love of God resides in the hearts of those who have given their lives to the Lord Jesus Christ, who have accepted Christ as their Savior, repented of their sins, and are serving the true and living God. So he says, surely you reward each person according to what he has done. God will do that. But our God is the loving God. He's a strong God, but he's a loving God. He's the just God, but he's a loving God. He loves us. That's why he sent his son, Jesus Christ, to die for our sins, to redeem us from the curse of sin, to redeem us from Satan's hand, to redeem us from living our eternity in hell away from him. Oh, how God so loves us. Almighty God can be trusted at all times. I wouldn't tell you to trust me at all times. I will surely fail you sometimes. The arm of flesh will fail you. You can't always trust your own. But God, you can always trust God. And you can always go to God on your knees by yourself quietly, sit in a rocking chair or sit below a tree or sit and just talk to God. And he hears. He answers. I can testify that God hears. He answers. He sustains. He keeps. He heals the hurts. He gives you joy. He gives you hope. He gives you the assurance that he's there. You feel his presence. You feel his presence. You know he's there. Put your trust in God at all times. Not sometimes. When the times are good, trust in God. When the times are mediocre, trust in God. When the times are bad, trust in God. In this time of COVID-19 and coronavirus, a lot of folks have run to God and trusted in him. They call upon him, and he's so merciful and loving. You call upon him, and he hears your call. I hope that after the coronavirus is finished, they will continue, and we will continue to trust in God and call upon him always. Because we have proven time and time again that he is God all by himself. And he never fails us. He answers us according to his will. And it is his will that none should perish. And his desire is so towards mankind. Oh, God is a sucker for mankind. He loves us so much. That is why I'm entreating you today. If you don't trust God at all times, practice every day to trust God at all times. Study the Word of God. See what the Bible says about God. You go on your knees or in a corner and talk to God, and you will see what God would have, what God has done for you. He'll show you the things that He has done for you. There are times you've been in trouble and He has rescued you miraculously. It's because He loves. He loves you with an everlasting love. He doesn't want to see you perish, but He wants to see you saved from sin and from hell by turning your life over to Him, by believing that His Son Jesus Christ came and died for us on the cross, shed His blood, that His blood could be shed to cover our sins. And when we repent of our sins and ask Him, Lord, I am a sinner. I was born in sin and shaped in iniquity. And at times I do sinful things, but I was born in sin. My nature is sin. I need to be born again, Lord. Father, I believe Your word. Talk to God. Father, in the name of Your Son, Jesus Christ, I believe Your word. And I'm a sinner. And I repent of being a sinner. And I've committed sins. I repent. Forgive me and wash me in that precious blood of Jesus Christ. And I guarantee you that if you try doing that, you will feel the change in your life. You will feel the change in your heart. You will feel like a new person. You will feel different. Your desires would be different. Your aims would be different. You will become more aligned with God, and you'll try to do things to please God. You'll become more loving, more kind. You will search God's word daily, and you'll strive to live to please God by the principles enshrined in His word. Anyone who has chosen to live evil lives and have died evil cannot see God's face. They go straight down to hell with the devil and the angels down there. But those of us who choose to repent of our sins, and sin touches us all the time. Once you are cognizant of it, you recognize you have done something wrong. Be quick to repent and turn away from it and try not to go that way again. God loves us. And I can tell you, the best thing you can do in life is to trust in God at all times. In good times, as a youth, as an adult, as a senior person, as somebody past 85 years. I was just told today, a lady who I'm inquiring about, she's past 85 years and she's still alive. I said, she's still alive. She's in her 90s. I said, God has kept her. That woman has to have had her trust in God to be still alive, because I know her a little bit. And if we trust in God, no matter what time God takes us, we will be with Him. We will be with Him. My younger sibling, whom I love so much, God has taken her. Situation was not the best. Circumstances under which it happened were not the best. 56 years old, she passed. I grieved, I cried. But I know she's in the Lord's hands. I kept my trust in God. Through the tears, I kept my trust in God, because I knew she made a decision to serve the Lord. I knew that night she was about to die, before she went to bed, she prayed and talked to God. She poured out her heart to God. She poured out her heart to God. And I thank God that His grace was great upon her life. And God's grace is always there to be great upon your life also. Listener today, if you have never given your life to Jesus Christ, if you've never repented of your sins, if you never trusted in Almighty God, I entreat you today, try God. Try reading the word of God. You'll see where we have all sinned and come short of the glory of God. And God sent Jesus Christ to die for us. He sent His only Son to die. He died. He shed His blood. He went into the grave. And he raised him from the dead as he said he would. And he took him up and back into heaven to be with him. Because he gave him a body like man. Because the only way Jesus Christ could have produced true salvation to man, he had to born, take on the flesh of a man's body, feel what we feel on earth, live as we live upon earth, and become the perfect sacrifice for our sins. Today I thank God. I thank God, I trust in God. I praise God today because He is Almighty God all by Himself. He is the only true and living God. No hands made Him. No man could have created God. God is God all by Himself. I cannot see Him, but I feel Him. I see Him in the Word. I see Him in my fellow brethren. See Him in the birds and the flowers and the trees and the animals. You can see God's creation. And man is God's crowning creation. You see, that is why we shouldn't hate one another. Because we are all sinners, born in sin and shaped in iniquity. Hatred should not be in our hearts. We should always be there to forgive. I might not trust you again, but I won't hate you. And if I can do something good to help you, I will do it. That's the attitude God has instilled in me. I praise God today. I want to entreat you, you trust in God at all times. Because my soul has found rest in God alone. And I know my salvation comes from Him. And I know that He alone is my rock. He's my fortress. And because of that, I will never be shaken. Because I trust in God. And you can say the same thing too. When you trust in God, nothing shakes you forever. It might make you totter, but you would not fall. You go back to God. You realize where your help is. You realize who your hope, where your strength is. Who is your maker? Who is your savior? Who is the supplier of your need? And you trust in Him. And said, God, I missed you a little bit, but God, I'm coming back to you. God loves us. God loves you. You are hearing me today. God loves you with an everlasting love. I can't love you with everlasting love. Your husband can't love you with everlasting love. Your wife can't love you with everlasting love. Your children can't love you with everlasting love. Only God can love you with an everlasting love. He so loved us that He sent His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, to take on the body of man. To live like we did, to feel the pangs of mankind, and to be crucified on the cross, and to die for us. And His blood was shed for our sins to be forgiven. And I guess He went and said, Father, here is my blood. I shed it for you. I did what you tell me to do. And we can all go to God. In the name of His Son, Jesus Christ, allowing the blood that was shed by Christ, wash us and cleanse us. Oh, I thank God. Trust in the Lord, oh God, at all times. You say you can't see God? God is seen in your mother, your father, your brother, your sister, your female being. God is seen in the flowers and the trees. God is all around. Open your eyes and you will see. Humble yourself before God. Admit that you're a sinner. Repent of your sins. Talk to Him by yourself. And you will feel the difference in your life. You will see the difference. You will think differently. You will think like God. You'll walk like God. You will love people like God. Like God expects you to. But there are times you will not let people overdo it with you. No, no. You'll have to be wise as a serpent and harmless as a dove. But trust in God. Today I entreat you. Trust in God. Put your trust in God. Some put their trust in money. Some put their trust in wealth, in houses. Some put their trust in the seer man. Those people who say that they see. And I call them witches and warlocks and wizards. And they conjure up all sorts of things and tell you all kind of nonsense. Hey, put your trust in God. Just read the Word of God. Go on your knees by yourself. Go in the corner by yourself. You talk to God in the name of His Son, Jesus Christ. And you will see what God will do for you. You will experience what God has for you. Our God is great. Our God is great. So today, I present to you that you can trust in God at all times, and He will never fail you yet. Have a great day. I'm Pastor Agnes Williams, wishing that all who has heard this message would put their trust in the Almighty God, find salvation, and live for God in Jesus' name. Amen.
No weapon for